Tia Clayton lose to Alexis James of Petersfield. And straight up, Karifta Trials is blazing. Welcome back to the channel, people. Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, thank you for making it Peter Lloyd World. Go ahead, please hit the subscribe button so we can continue to grow. When you do that, hit the notification bell so you know when the next video drops. We drop a video at least once a day here on Peter Lloyd World. Also, if you enjoy the content, please hit that like button. And finally, leave your thoughts after this sports analysis where we take a look at and we break down the races. So, are you ready? Yep. Good to go. Well, first off, let's say that Karifta Trials has started this Friday, the 10th of March, with a bang. First up, let's take a look at the three heats of the under 20 girls 400 meters, and some amazing runs were set. Let's first look at heat number one, where one of the favorites to take this event, Ricky and Russell of Homewood Tech, delivered a blistering win of 53.85 to qualify in the upcoming finals.
Speculation aplenty if we can see a sub 51 second 400 meters at championships, or even this year from Russell. Let's see how that one goes. But first, she must navigate over this 400 meter course. Traveling well, Dejanie Cato of Port Antonio. And she leads them on the outside. And of course, she has to get a great start. But now Russell begins to motor with just under 200 meters to go. Bringing with her Brissett and Beckford. And it's Russell and Beckford, the top two at the moment. Brissett tries to keep in touch, so does Cato. Russell, Beckford, Brissett, Cato, that's the top four, that's the order. And Ricky and Russell will come to the line, 53.84, ahead of Beckford of Edmund Allen and Brissett. 53.84, 54.72, and 55.77 for Brissett. Cato, 56.63.
Heat 2 was won by Kaycian Powell of Edmund Allen in a time of 53.85, the same time that Rickian Russell of Homewood Tech had ran and won heat number one in. Take a look.
Sent off and running for heat number two. Dockery of Lacovia gets up very well. And already is on the heels of Casey and Powell of Edwin Allen. So that's the top two at the moment. Trying to step now looks to be DeAndre Kelly of Excelsior. And those are three athletes, Dockery, Powell and Kelly, all run together as they now pass the 200 meter mark and try to run the curve very hard. So it's Powell of Edwin Allen taking them through the first 300 meters ahead of Dockery of Lacovia and Kelly of Excelsior. On the outside, Brady of Homewood Technical running very brave, but it's Powell who will take this one. Brady seems to be settling in for second ahead of Kelly of Excelsior. 53.83, the flash time.
And it was Abigail Campbell of Heidel High School who ran and won heat number three in a time of 54.53.
Sent off and running for the final heat of the under 20 girls 400 meters. Patterson of St. Catherine travels very fast over the first 100 meters. And now Abigail Campbell of Heidel has Hazard in her sights. Further to her rear inside is Kellyanne Carr of Edwin Allen. Paris Brown of Port Antonio tries to keep in touch, but it's still Patterson of St. Catherine. Abigail Campbell now inching very closer to the lead. Campbell, Patterson, the top two. Patterson over Campbell. And behind them, Kellyanne Carr of Edwin Allen. Now Abigail Campbell steps forward ahead of Patterson. And they'll settle for one and two. Carr will run fast into third. 54.50. The flash time for Abigail Campbell of Hydell. .62 for Carr.
Now, MVP's Tia Clayton made her appearance in the class, the under 20, heat one of the 100 meters at the Charifta Trials. Now, we explained to you yesterday that although she is a pro, the fact that she is under 20 means that she qualifies, because Charifta, it doesn't matter if you're a pro or you're an amateur. Now, you just saw her running that very well. It was a wind assisted 7.05, I think, in the 60 meter dash. However, we did say yesterday that one of the possible spoilers in the class one girls 100 meters, well, in the under 20 100 meters, would be Alexis James of Petersfield. Remember, Alexis James, we told you yesterday, she is the silver medalist in last year's World Under 20, which was run in Cali, Colombia, girls 100 meter hurdles, second only to Karika Hill, formerly of Hydell. And well, let's just say we were right, and it appears as if Petersfield's Alexis James delivered and shocked many, because she handily trounced the remarkable Tia Clayton. Now, I have to, well, watch the race and then we talk. James won heat one in a time of 11.24 to qualify, with Tia Clayton coming second from MVP Track Club, running 11.53 to take the second place, and Tony Ann Forbes of Edwin Allen won 11.59.
Williams 3, James 4, Clayton in lane 5, they're sent on their way. Blistering start and brilliant running from Alexis James. Tia Clayton tracks her well into second. Well, we wondered about the time at Western Champs. Now, maybe a little confirmation. It's positive 3.1 meters per second, the wind speed, first of all. The time on the clock, 11.24 for Alexis James.
So, as you heard there, that 11.24 doesn't qualify because the wind speed was over plus 2.4. It was plus 3.1. So it definitely doesn't count. James ran a solid race, ran right through the line. However, she looked very convincing in that win to me. But it also could be that, and this is the second aspect of it, that Tia Clayton could just have been tracking her and just doing just enough to get through to the finals. We have seen both Tina and Tia Clayton do that in previous races, not very concerned about winning, but just making sure that they are, you know, they get through. But it looks to me as if in this instance, Alexis James is going to be a factor in that finals tomorrow. We're going to be doing the other 200 meter girls and the women's 100 meters very soon. But I don't know. You tell me what you think. James looks really good. Were you surprised? Are you disappointed with Tia Clayton, or do you think Tia Clayton is playing possum? Now, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, hit the like button. Remember, you're royals, kings, and queens. Bless up!